So what's it like directing Robin? I mean, it's you're not only a good friend of yours, but
well, not you know, he's a good friend and everything, but he's one of the biggest stars in the world, and he's a great comedian and a great actor. But that is the kind of coolest thing about this process. I would say, hey, why don't we do one this way? And not once in the whole time, did they ever say no, And he liked that because we would do all different things. We'd take things and make things ugly, and there's a couple, really ugly, and then go the other direction and go and be silly. And some of it stayed in, some of it didn't, And I think once you do I've been on so many sets when the director, you say your line, the guy wrote it or whatever, and he doesn't like it because he's not going to use it or it wasn't how he envisioned it,
right.
And he makes the actor feel embarrassed and feels bad. I don't. You say his line, I go, okay, that's good. Now let's try another one. Then I go back in the editing. Sometimes I'm wrong. I'm glad I let that. But it's even actors that don't ad lib or change lines. If you say that's good, now let's just ad lib one, and that's always the best take because they know that they've already done a good performance and they just relax all the way through it.
So you're not a big whispering director. You're not dragging them to the side going, that's wrong, that's wrong.
Damn, man, I can't use that. No, man. It's just, you just hire people who you believe in and know are going to do a good job and try to encourage people instead of try to beat it into them.
Yeah. So you're not going to be Michael Mann anytime soon?
No, but you know what? He's never going to be me.
That's true. That's for sure.
He may be a lot, he may be a lot more well known and a lot wealthier than me. But you know what? when he's sick, I guarantee you there'll be a lot more people around my hospital bed than that fucker's.
Well, that's honest. So, you're also a very daring director in that there was one nude scene in this film, and it was not the girl who everybody wanted to see naked. It was Robin Williams.
Yeah, it was. You know what's funny is, Robin Williams, his cock and balls are out in this film, and I've successfully made a movie that nobody even talks to me about that after they see it. You know what I mean? There's just so much shit in the movie, they go, oh, yeah. Yeah, Mark was nude. That's fucked up, yo. Yeah, and, that was his idea. He was like, and he goes, I was thinking about doing a knee. And then I came back and I said, yeah. I was thinking of, who's that painter that, he always has like guys in business suits. It's the 80s guy. It's not Nagel, but it's like, and they're always there like in a business suit and a tie. You know what I'm talking about? They're flying through the air. I was kind of seeing that.
I think I kind of understand.
Do you know what I'm talking about? Yeah, they were everywhere, but I was kind of seeing it that way. And then when he said, nude, I go, let me think about it. I walked away and I went, yeah, that does make sense, And there was, I had cut it earlier where you see him nude earlier. And it took people way out. So it's where it is now,
Well, people aren't completely sure it's him, I think. There were discussions last night afterwards.
Yeah, was that him or
whether
not?
That was actually him or a stunt body or something like that. The other thing that was surreal about it was the idea that you guys peeled his back off, his back hair off.
I said last
think
night.
Of him as like furry
I said last night we really did lose the bear community.
What was that all about? Why was that?
That was his joy. Like he shows up that way, and I was like, "Wow, people are really going to see your balls now." You lost all that manscaping. Just that would have been your fig leaf. That would have covered that shit up.
Did he just decide he didn't like having a hairy back in public? I mean, it's
there is no discussion about his hair, but yeah, that might be. I'm sure that will be something people talk about. It is killing me, though. It is pretty funny. Nobody, you're the first person to say, hey, dude, he's nude. What's up with that?
What's with Robin's dick?
Isn't that funny?
Yeah, we've been talking about it for so many years.
Well, we finally see Mr. Happy.
That's right. It's been 20 years.
He really does have big balls. That's what we learned.
He wasn't just saying.
But I jumped off the diving board nude, too.
Just to make him feel comfortable or to see what it was like?
I'd like to say that it was like that, but it was really more like a little bit about trying to get, that and then... And then how many chances in life are you going to be to jump off a public pool nude?
You cleared this out.
It was awesome. It was, and I just did it fast because I know the crew and I knew they would have rolled on it. I go, did you roll? And they go, no. And of course they did. So.
Home video cameras. It's cell phones.
Yeah. Well, it's just I'm watching dailies and all of a sudden this thing that looks like a nude baby comes flying over the diving board.